Yo, what's up, Cavs Nation? I'm your host and the man of the people, Truitt McGlone, and we're coming at you with a special edition of Hallway Hangout, Intervention Edition. Hey, we're going to be talking about problem solving up in this school. I'm here with
Austin Tile.
Austin, what is a pro to watching a mindful minute?
Oh, I love those videos.
They help me focus in class, and I can get all my work done when I watch a mindful minute.
Ever watch one?
Nope.
I'm here with
Connor.
Connor, what is a con to watching a mindful minute?
A con is it tends to be a little too long, and I can't focus that long.
Let's take some time to enjoy a mindful minute.
I don't know how they do it. They go from one class to a passing period, then back to another class with a completely different subject.
You go through the day without feeling how you feel. You just wake up, do your morning routine, go to school, come back home, and you don't stop, you know? And with mindfulness, you do stop.
Mindful body, feet are flat on the floor. Become aware of your body. So just notice your body. Mindful minute usually happens at the start of class. What I'm trying to do is give them a chance to arrive, is to give them a chance to make it all the way into the room with their bodies and their awareness. I'm gonna turn off my voice and let you breathe for a couple of minutes without my voice.
She tells us to listen to our breathing and recognize the fact that you are breathing. Letting you stop for a minute, just reflect on yourself and how you feel.
When I was really stressing and worrying about stuff, when I took these mindful minutes, it's like, I'm gonna be fine. Like, I'm gonna get through this.
It's a very easy, very simple way to help kids arrive, to quiet down their nervous systems and help the brain turn on and get learning ready.
Today, our focus is problem solving. Let's be real. Sometimes it is the problem itself that is causing us to have unwanted emotions and keeping us from solving a situation. Sometimes we need to step back to figure out what the actual problem is. For example, you might think your problem is not doing your math homework, when the actual problem is that you get really anxious every time you think about doing your homework because you don't understand geometry. When you avoid your homework, your anxiety goes away. If that's the case, then we need to do some problem solving to figure out how to help you understand the material and tolerate some anxiety. There are 7 steps to problem solving. The first step is to describe the problem situation.
I want to go to Mason for the weekend, but my parents said no because I'm missing assignments. I'm failing 2 classes and I haven't been doing the laundry. I feel angry and sad because I'm going to miss out on a fun weekend.
Remember that when we describe a problem situation, we want just the facts, but the facts also include the description of our emotional response. The core of the problem is that Cam thinks he'll miss out on a lot of fun with his friends. The second step is to check the facts. Does our interpretation of the situation fit the facts? Ask yourself this question. Am I interpreting the situation correctly?
My parents said I can't spend the weekend at Mason's house because my grades are terrible and I haven't done laundry in 3 weeks.
Are you thinking in extremes?
I am going to miss out on everything this weekend. I won't know what anyone is talking about next week, and everyone will think I'm a loser for not being around.
These thoughts are all or nothing, Cam. Not everything is going to happen this weekend at your friend's house, and not everyone will be talking about it. The third thought is a catastrophic thinking. When other friends have missed something over the weekend, you didn't dismiss them as losers. It seems pretty unlikely that everyone will think you are a loser. But if you don't get your assignments completed, your grades up, and your chores done this week, it is pretty unlikely that your parents will let you go, even if the worst thing happened. Could you imagine coping well? You can say to yourself, I can keep in touch with my friends through texting and social media over the weekend. I can get my assignments completed so I don't have to miss out on the following weekend too.
I'm still faced with the problem and I want to get my emotions in check. I understand why my parents said no, but I still want to go.
Then let's go to the third step. Identify your goals and solving the situation. Cam, what is your goal?
My goal is to get to Mason's house for the weekend.
Now let's go to the fourth step, brainstorming. Plenty of solutions. In brainstorming, the trick is to write down anything and everything that comes to mind, not judging or throwing away any ideas.
So I can go to my friend's house anyway. I could do my laundry every day. I could ask for extra credit in my class. I could actually finish my Alex topics. I could stay up all night and do my homework. I could just run away from home.
Step 5 is to pick one solution that is likely to work. It is important to consider the solution and determine if it could work, would not work, or could possibly work.
If I go to my friend's house anyway, my parents will show up, make a scene, and embarrass me in front of my friends. I can't ask for extra credit if I haven't done my actual missing assignments. I could stay up all night and do my homework instead of playing Fortnite with my friends. I could also work in some laundry to give my mind a break from studying.
The 6th step is to put the solution into action.
I'm going to put my phone on Do Not Disturb, work on my geometry homework, get my Alex topics finished, and write the essay for Darius's class. Ask my sister to proofread it and get a start on laundry, taking breaks from homework whenever I hear the washer and dryer finish. Then I will ask my parents if I can go to Mason's house after I am able to get all of that done.
The 7th and last step is to evaluate each outcome after you work through it. Cam, did your solution solve the problem?
Actually, it did.
How did you reward yourself?
I showed my parents that I was able to turn it around and accept my responsibility. And they said I could go to Mason's house before I even had a chance to ask. The time with my friends was okay, but I definitely overreacted. All we did was watch Mason Brown play Roblox. I was actually happier with myself and I got grades up and my parents were proud.
If it would have worked out for Cam, I would suggest that he evaluate why the solution didn't work and what he could have done differently. Let's recap the 7 steps of problem solving. Describe the problem situation, check the facts, identify the goals in your problem situation, brainstorm solutions, pick a realistic solution, put the solution into action, evaluate the outcome. Thanks for staying with us during this hallway hangout intervention edition. We'll see you next time.